Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaliya Ammaal Mahalingam Engineering College. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture on Engineering Thermodynamics. And this is module number 10. So we are discussing on module number 10, Psychrometric Properties and Processes. So this is lecture number 6 on psychrometrics. We recap from the previous lecture. So in the previous lectures, we discussed about the psychrometric properties, psychrometric chart. The psychrometric chart is used to take the psychrometric properties like specific humidity, relative humidity, dry bulb temperature, wet bulb temperature, dew point temperature, enthalpy of air and water vapor mixture, and the specific volume of air. And we discussed the psychrometric processes. And in the earlier few lectures, we solved a few problems on the psychrometric processes, and we continue. So in this lecture, the topic is problem in psychrometric properties and psychrometric processes. So we continue with the problems, and the learning outcome for the students at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to solve problems on the psychrometric properties and psychrometric processes. So we take example number 16. So this is from May 2019 and November 2019 question paper. An air water vapor mixer enters an air conditioning unit at a pressure of 1 bar, 38 degree dry bulb temperature and a relative humidity of 75%. The mass of dry air entering is 1 kilogram. The air vapor mixer leaves the air conditioning unit at 1 bar, 18 degree Celsius and 85% relative humidity. The moisture condensed leaves at 18 degrees Celsius. Sketch the process in the psychrometric chart and determine the heat transfer rate for the process. So the given data, P1 equal to 1 bar, T1 equal to 38 degrees Celsius, relative humidity phi1 equal to 0.75, the mass of the air G equal to 1 kilograms per second, and P2 equal to 1 bar, T2 temperature T2 equal to 18 degrees Celsius, and phi 2 equal to 0.85, relative humidity at the outlet equal to 0.85. Now from the steam table, at a temperature T1 equal to 38 degrees Celsius, the saturation pressure PS1 equal to 0.06624 bar and the enthalpy HG1 equal to 2570.8 kilojoules per kilogram, and the partial pressure of water vapor PW1 equal to PS1 into phi1, where PS1 is saturation pressure, phi1 is relative humidity. So, this is equal to 0.0064 into 0.75 equal to 0.049868 bar. And using this partial pressure of water vapor, we calculate the specific humidity of air at inlet, W1 equal to 0.622 PW1 by P minus PW1 equal to, substitute the numerical value is 0.622 0.04968 divided by 1 minus 0.04968 equal to 0.0325 kilogram per kilogram of air. And this is the process. So the air enters with the condition 75% relative humidity and 30 degree Celsius, and leaves with 80 degree Celsius and 85% relative humidity. So these are all the two processes, and you have a cooling coil here. So the cooling coil reduces the temperature as well as the specific humidity of the air. So the inlet condition and outlet conditions are shown in the figure. Again from the steam table, at T2 equal to 18 degrees Celsius, the saturation pressure PS equal to 0.02062 bar, PS2 equal to 0.02062 bar, HF2 enthalpy of water is 75.5 kilojoules per kilogram, HG2 enthalpy of vapor 2534.5 kilojoules per kilogram. Now the partial pressure of water vapor, once again using the relative humidity, so PW2 equal to PS2 into PS2 into phi2, which is 0.02062 into 0.85 equal to 0.0175 bar. Now the specific humidity at the outlet, W2 equal to 0.622 PW2 by P minus PW2, P is the total pressure, 1 bar. So 0.622 into 0.0175 divided by 1 minus 0.0175 equal to 0.011 kg per kg of air. So this is the W2 at the outlet specific humidity. And the heat transfer rate equal to W2HG2 minus W1HG1. This is the heat transfer due to the water vapor removal, and the specific heat of air Cp into T2 minus T1 plus W1 into W1 minus W2 into HF2. So, this is the enthalpy due to the water, loss of water. So, substituting all the numerical values, W2.011, HG2 2534.5 minus W1.0325 and HG1 equal to 2570.8 plus 1.005 Cp of the air, 18 minus 38 temperature plus 0.0325 minus 0.011 into 75.5. So, calculating the heat transfer equal to 74 kilojoules. And the answer to the problem, we have to calculate the amount of heat transfer. So, the amount of heat transfer equal to 74 kilojoules. In example number 17, atmospheric air at 38 degrees Celsius and 25% relative humidity passes through an evaporator cooler. If the final temperature of the air is 18 degrees Celsius, how much water is added per kg of dry air and what is the final relative humidity? So, this is from May 2019 and November 2012 Anna University question paper. And this is the evaporator cooling process. So, one is the initial state. So, the given data, one is T1 equal to 38 degrees Celsius and Φ1 equal to 25% and T2 equal to 18 degrees Celsius. Now, from steam table at T1 equal to 38 degrees Celsius, saturation pressure 0.06624 bar and the enthalpy of vapor equal to HG1 equal to 2570.8 kilojoules per kilogram. And partial pressure of water vapor at inlet. So, based on the relative humidity, so PW1 equal to PS1 into Φ1 equal to 0.06624 into 0.25 equal to 0.01656 bar. And the specific humidity at the inlet using the partial pressure of water vapor, W1 equal to 0.0622 into PW1 divided by P minus PW1 equal to 0.622 into 0.01656 divided by 1 minus 0.01656 equal to 0.0105 kilogram per kilogram of air. And from steam table now, at 18 degrees Celsius, the saturation pressure is 0.02062 bar and the HG2 is 2534.5 kilojoules per kilogram. And the for evaporative cooling process, H1 equal to H2. So, H1 is CpA into T1 plus W1 into H1. And H2 equal to CpA into T2 and W2 H2. So, substituting numerical values. So, everything is known excepting W2. So, CpA 1.005 into 38 plus 0.0105 into 2570.8 equal to 1.005 into 18 plus W2 into 2534.5. So, solving this equation, W2 equal to 0.0186 kg per kg of air. The amount of water added, so equal to W2 minus W1. So, W2 is the specific humidity at the end of the process minus W1 is the specific humidity at the beginning of the process. 0.0186 minus 0.0105 equal to 0.0081 kg per kg of air. And using this, we calculate. So, the amount of water removed, so 0.0081 equal to 0.622 into PW by P minus PW equal to 0.622 into PW, so P equal to 1 minus PW. So, solving this equation, the partial pressure of water vapor equal to 0.00128 bar. And using this, the final relative humidity, so Phi equal to PW2 by PS2 equal to 0.0128 divided by 0.02062 equal to 0.62, which is 62%. So, the final relative humidity is 62% and the amount of water vapor added is 0.0081 kg per kg of air. And we take example number 18. So, 90 meter cube of air per minute at 20 degrees Celsius and 70% relative humidity is heated until its temperature becomes 30 degrees Celsius. Calculate the relative humidity of the heated air and the heat added per minute. So, this is from May 2017 question paper. And the given data, volume V equal to 90 meter cube per minute, temperature T1 equal to 20 degrees Celsius, Φ1, relative humidity Φ1 equal to 75% and T2 equal to 30 degrees Celsius. And again from the steam table at 20 degrees Celsius, the saturation pressure is 0.02337 bar and the enthalpy of vapor Hg1 equal to 2538.2 kilojoules per kilogram. And the partial pressure of water vapor using the specific relative humidity Pw1 equal to Ps1 into phi1, which is 0.02337 into 0.75 equal to 0.0175 bar. And the specific humidity at the inlet, so using this partial pressure, W1 equal to 0.622 Pw1 by P minus Pw1 equal to 0.622 into 0.0175 divided by 1 minus 0.0175 equal to 0.011 kg per kg of air. Then dew point temperature. So dew point temperature is the saturation pressure corresponding to this Pw1, 0.017 bar. So from the steam table, the DPT, dew point temperature is 15.3 degree Celsius. Enthalpy of air at inlet condition, H1 equal to enthalpy of air plus enthalpy of water vapor. So Cp into T1, Cpa into T1 plus W1 into Hg1 plus 1.88 into T1 minus DPT equal to this substitute numerical values. H1 equal to 1.005 into 20 plus 0.01011 into 2538.2 plus 1.88 into 20 minus 15.3 equal to 48.3 kilojoules per kilogram. And from the steam table again, at T2 equal to 30 degrees Celsius, PS2 equal to 0.04242 bar, Hg2 equal to 2556.4 kilojoules per kilogram. The relative humidity at the outlet, so phi2, equal to Pw1. Actually, the equation is Pw2 by PS2. For sensible heating process, there is no change in the water pressure. So, partial pressure of water vapor. So, Pw1 equal to Pw2. So, Pw1 divided by PS2 equal to 0.0175 divided by 0.04242 is equal to 41.2%. And the final enthalpy of the air, H2 equal to Cpa into T2 plus W1. Again, W1 specific humidity equal to W1 equal to W2 for insensible heating process. So, W1 into Hg2 plus 1.88 into T2 minus DPT. So, substituting numerical values, H2 equal to 1.005 into 30 plus 0.011 into 2556.4 plus 1.88 into 30 minus 15.3 equal to 58.8 kilojoules per kilogram. And mass of the air from the given volume, we have to calculate mass of the air equal to PA by PAV divided by R into T1. So, PA is the partial pressure of air, which is total pressure minus the partial pressure of water vapor. So, 1.001325 minus 0.0175 into 100. So, to convert pressure bar into kilopascal into 90 meter cube divided by 0.287 into 293 equal to 106.57 kilograms per minute. And the amount of heat added per minute equal to M into H2 minus H1, which is 106.57 into 58.8 minus 48.3 equal to 1118.98 kilojoules per minute. So, this is the amount of heat added, the answer to the problem, amount of heat added per minute. And example number 19, it is required to design an air conditioning plant for a small office room for the following winter condition. Outdoor condition, 14 degree Celsius dry bulb temperature, 10 degree Celsius wet bulb temperature. The required conditions are 20 degree Celsius dry bulb temperature and 60% relative humidity. The amount of air circulation is 0.3 meter cube per minute per person. Seating capacity is 60. The required condition is achieved first by heating, then and then by adiabatic humidifying. Determine the following. 1. The heating capacity of the coil in kilowatt and the surface temperature required if the bypass factor of the cooling coil is 0.4, the capacity of the humidifier. 2. The capacity of the humidifier. So, the question is from November 2016 question paper. And write down the given data, outdoor condition, 14 degree Celsius dry bulb temperature and 10 degree Celsius wet bulb temperature. Required condition, 20 degree Celsius dry bulb temperature and 60% relative humidity. Amount of air circulation is 0.3 meter cube per minute per person. And seating capacity is 60. And the bypass factor is 0.4. So, we are going to solve this problem using the psychrometric chart. So, this is the psychrometric chart. X-axis we have the dry bulb temperature. Y-axis we have the specific humidity. The blue color line for relative humidity, 10%, 20%, 30%. The last line is 100%. and this red color line is for wet bulb temperature as well as enthalpy of the air water vapor mixer. So the wet bulb temperature is indicated here on the red color line, and the enthalpies are given above the line, and the green color line is the specific volume of the air. Now the first condition, 14 degree Celsius day bulb temperature, and the final condition is actually how to get the value. So initial condition is 14 degree day bulb temperature, 10 degree wet bulb temperature, required condition 20 degree Celsius day bulb temperature, 60% relative humidity. So this is the 14 degree Celsius day bulb temperature and 10 degree Celsius wet bulb temperature. So this is the point 1, and we have to achieve the 3. So what is 3 now? So 3 is the 20 degree Celsius dry bulb temperature and 60% relative humidity. So this is the final condition. So first we have to achieve by heating. So for sensible heating, you draw an horizontal line. So this horizontal line for sensible heating, because for sensible heating there is no change in the specific humidity. Now from the point 3, you draw an inclined line along the enthalpy line. So this is evaporative cooling, adiabatic humidifying. So there is no change in the enthalpy for this process, and this is the point 2. So the final condition is achieved by first by sensible heating and then cooling. So sensible heating and then adiabatic humidifying. Then this is the condition here where the temperature is 24 degrees Celsius. Then the final temperature will calculate. So the properties here, H1 equal to 29 kilojoules per kilogram, W1 equal to W2 equal to 6.5 grams per kg, and H2 equal to H3 equal to 42 kilojoules per kilogram, and W3 equal to 9 grams per kg. So these are all the properties taken from the stoichiometric chart. Now we calculate mass of the air equal to volume by specific volume. So specific volume is 0.82 meter cube per kg. So mass of the air equal to volume by specific volume, capital V by small v. So 60 into 0.3. So 60% 0.3 meter cube per minute divided by 60, that gives in kilograms per second, divided by 0.8 equal to 0.366 kilogram per second. And capacity of the heating coil, MA into H2 minus H1, which is 0.366 into 42 minus 29 equal to 4.76 kilowatt. Capacity of the humidifier equal to mass of the water mass of the water removed from the air. So MA into W3 minus W2 equal to 0.366 into 0.009 minus 0.0065 equal to 0.0915 grams per second. And the surface temperature of the heating coil. So using the bypass factor for the cooling coil, T4 minus T2 divided by T4 minus T1. So for surface temperature of the coil minus the final temperature divided by surface temperature of the coil minus the initial temperature of the air. So substituting 0.4 equal to T4 minus 24 divided by T4 minus 14. So 0.4 into T4 into 14, T4 minus 14 equal to T4 minus 24. And solving this equation, the T4 equal to 30.7 degree Celsius. So that is what the final temperature. So the final temperature is marked here in the chart. So the final temperature is 30.7 degree Celsius. So this is the surface temperature of the heating coil. Then example number 20 from the November 2017 question paper. A room receives air from the atmosphere 10 degree Celsius and the relative humidity 30%, and it is then heated to 20 degree Celsius by sensible heating process. The air is then mixed with the steam to reach 25 degree Celsius and relative humidity 65%. If the atmospheric pressure is 101 kilopascal, the volume flow rate of air at the entry is 50 meter cube per hour. Find the heat transfer in the heating section and the steam flow rate in the humidifier. So first there is a heating process, and then there is a steam addition, that is water vapor addition. Heating and then water vapor addition. The initial data given, initial temperature 10 degree Celsius, specific humidity 30%, final temperature is 20 degree Celsius, and T2 is the temperature after a sensible heating 20 degree Celsius, T3 is the temperature, final temperature 25 degree Celsius, and the final relative humidity is 65%, and the volume flow rate is 500 meter cube per hour. So the mass of the air, we calculate the mass of the air. So actually this data we have taken from the stoichiometric chart. Look into the stoichiometric chart. So this is the stoichiometric chart. So the initial condition 10 degree, relative humidity 30%, heating after heating 20 degree, and final condition 25 degree Celsius and relative humidity 65%. Now you take the chart. Initial condition 10 degree and relative humidity 30%. This is the one. And the final after heating process, the temperature is 20 degree Celsius. So this is the sensible heating process. So initially 10 degree 30% relative humidity, locate the point 1 and then draw a horizontal line for sensible heating process. So it will meet at 20 degree Celsius, stop here. So this is point 2. Then there is a heating process. So the final condition is 25 degree Celsius and 60% relative humidity, and this is point 3. Now we have to take the properties. H1 equal to 18.5 kilojoules per kilogram, V1 equal to 0.803 meter cube per kilogram, H2 equal to 28.5 kilojoules per kilogram, and W2 equal to 2.5 grams per kg, and W3 equal to 12.5 grams per kg. So all the properties you have to note down from the chart. Now we come back to the previous slide. So here we calculate the mass of the air, volume divided by the specific volume. So volume is 500 meter cube per hour. So 500 divided by 3600 into 0.803 is the specific volume. So 1.73 kilograms per second. So heat transfer in the heating section, MA into H2 minus H1, which is 1.73 into 28.5 minus 18.5, 17.3 kilojoules per second. And the steam flow rate in the humidifier, MA into W3 minus W2, which is 1.73 into 12.5 minus 2.5 equal to 17.3 grams per second. So these are all the two questions. Find the heat transfer in the heating section and the steam flow rate in the humidifier. So these are all the answers to the problem. So you have to draw the psychrometric chart carefully, then we will get the answer. So these are the reference book I used for preparing the slides. So you can also refer to it for additional information or the problem. Thank you for watching. You can write to my mail ID for any queries or clarification. You subscribe the channel. I have uploaded more than 100 YouTube videos on the all thermal engineering subjects, and gate questions also I am solving and uploading. So kindly subscribe the channel so that you will get the updated videos for your better learning. So thank you. We'll meet again.